So ultimately, the important message that's coming out is that you will have to come up with internationally accepted norms or treaties. If you don't come up with that, it's going to be difficult. But today is not the time. There's complete distrust and mistrust amongst nations, thanks to the Snowden revelations. And therefore, the concept of norms in cyberspace has assumed tremendous significance. Countries are saying, you must have these norms of behavior. These need to be common minimum standards of behavior that must be complied with by nations across the world. More so in the context of minimizing the harm by cybersecurity breaches, and also for the purposes of fostering international operations and cooperation amongst each other. And I think this is the buzzword that we are beginning to hear in the last 1 year very much. In fact, that brings us to the bigger issue. How do we determine what are the rules of the road? What are the norms of behavior? And work has already started in good earnestness. We had the London Conference in Cyberspace, the Budapest Conference in Cyberspace, the Seoul Conference in Cyberspace, and the GCCS in Hague earlier this year. And almost all of these conferences have been talking about what could be the common minimum denominators of minimum accepted behavior in cyberspace by countries. And I think it's this particular area that will get more and more attention as we go forward. Also, there's another talk. Another school of jurists say, how about applying the international humanitarian law to cyberspace? We have the law of the seas. Why can't we apply that? That's also one part process that's beginning to take some traction. However, no final words said yet. But clearly, one thing is clear. We are in a world, it's an interconnected, ubiquitous world. And in this world, the data repositories are the kings. The intermediaries, the service providers, are the guys who have all your information. Your Google today knows you far more better than your father, your mother, your wife, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your son or daughter. That's Google for you. Okay? So these are the data repositories. How are they going to actually shape up with dealing with your privacy, with issues pertaining to personal online liberties? Those are issues that we have not even begun to start talking about. And those issues will have to be looked at.